Guys, I have another experiment for you today. So I have a yam that I planted in this container. This is one of the St. Vincent yam that I took all the way from Jamaica. Then I dug a hole just right here. I'm going to try and see if I can make a yam hill and plant another one right here. And then I can compare to see which one does better. So I'm in the greenhouse and I make some makeshift trellis. And I'm going to see what happened, guys. So these yam seeds are the same age old, everything. They started off the same time. I placed one in the container. And then I put another one in a plastic bag with some coco coir so it can start rooting. And then I just dug the hole to make the dirt a bit looser, I guess. I've never planted yam in Jamaica, guys. So this is all experiment for me myself. So I just dig the hole there, then I'm going to load it back with the dirt that I just took out. So it's a bit loose, so the yam root and everything won't struggle to find its way down. Then I'm going to make a yam hill. I'm going to plant this thing together, so let's go. So I'm just going to fill back the hole with the exact same dirt that I took out of it, guys. So now it's a bit looser, so the yam won't struggle to find its way down. Well, that's the whole idea, guys. I'm trying this thing. Do you think it's gonna work, guys? So this is the exact dirt that I took out that I'm putting back in. But for me, digging it up, doing it, turn it over, much looser to work with. So I just have the same dirt filling back the hole with. Guys, I'm so excited for this growing season. You know, last year I got a really good size yam seed, but because I had to go away for that extended period of time, I wasn't able to take care of it properly. So this year, because last year I had a yellow yam, and the yellow yams are take longer time to mature. This year I'm going with two different types of white yam. I have Renta yam and I have St. Vincent. And I'm going to see if they're actually going to make a difference, because those are supposed to mature much quicker than the yellow yam. So I'm going to try that. But no, I'm not giving up on the yellow yam. I just don't have any at the moment, and I was able to source any. Now it's like almost May. Today is the end. So I should have sourced it already. But if I get all of any by the first week of May, I will still do the yellow yam. But at the moment, this experiment is a white yam, okay? So I filled back the hole like that. Then I'm going to get some extra dirt, guys, because I have to make a yam hill, okay? My dad will be so proud of me. My dad used to plant yam, guys. But in Jamaica, usually the sons will go to the farm with dad. So I've never really seen firsthand how to make yam hill or anything. But it can be hard to make a hill. So that's what my yam hill looking like, guys. I'm all excited. So that's my yam hill. Probably make a little bit higher. Yeah, put a little bit more on top, guys. So that's my yam hill. Yeah, and I think that should give you a nice size St. Vincent yam. If you don't know what the St. Vincent yam look like, guys, I'm going to post a picture above. It's a nice, big, fat, bumpy type looking yam, okay? So I'm going to put a picture above. This particular one, I tasted, guys, in Jamaica. I was in Portland, Jamaica, and a friend of mine went down. We were cooking. I never forgot I was cooking. And his wife was saying, is there any yam? And he just said, soon come. And he went down the bottom of the garden and came back with a massive piece of yam. And it was nice, guys. And also, I don't grow any yam that I haven't sampled before. So I sampled it and it was nice. So let's see what's rooted in here. So all this, guys, is my starting mix of my coco coir. Oops. So let's see what yam in here is ready to go. Oh, I can see one here with a little thing. I can see another one that is way ahead. So let's do this one, guys. You can see right here, look like the yam about to form up and do the thing. Looking really, really good, guys. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to put it in the ground sideways. I'm not sure which way to put it. I'm going to put it sideways because I can see root coming from all angles. But this bit looks like it's about to grow and form a piece of yam. So I think I'll put it that way because that piece seems to be forming that way.
So I'm gonna put it down that way and then put back my heel like that. Yes, guys, are you excited? What do you think? You think it's gonna work? Because this is cold England. The soil is cold at the moment I'm doing this, but as you can see, the yam is rearing to go out. So even though the weather haven't warmed up as I would like before I plant this beauty out, I just have to take a risk because the yam is ready. The yam wants to grow, guys. The yam wants to grow. So there's my yam head planted in my yam hill. So let's take it closer so you can see. So that's my yam hill. I mean, it could be higher, but it's a good couple inches. Plus, I have the bit in the bottom that I dig out, so the plant should have some space to spread out. So that's the St. Vincent yam here. St. Vincent yam there. I'm just leaving the pumpkin to grow up and then transplant them. Probably if I dig away, you probably can see. Let's see if you can see anything. Oh, you can see the root. You can see the root there. I don't want to disturb it too much. So yes, guys, there's two St. Vincent yam. So I have one there and I will have one here. And then in a few weeks' time, I'll show you an update of these beauties popping up.
It's been a week, guys, since I planted the yam. You can see the yam in the container coming up along with pumpkins and everything. I need to remove these pumpkins, but you can see nice yam growing in the container. The yam that's on the hill haven't shown any appearance yet. So the yam, where I think the yam hill for, that's not coming up yet. So far, the yam in the container is the one that's showing more progress at the moment. So I'll give you an update in another week or two, and hopefully this one will make an appearance as well. So that's the comparison of both of them growing on in the greenhouse at the moment. It's been 2 weeks and the yam in the ground finally making an appearance, guys. So that's after 2 weeks, it's right there. But the one in the pot now leaning towards his pole, so it's way ahead, guys. So the one in the pot is doing way better, growing much faster than the one that I placed in the yam hill. There it is, but you never know, it's not the start of the game that determines it. So let's see how they get on in the end. But both of them now showing an appearance, which is quite good. It's a bit overcast day today, but the weather haven't been too bad. So let's see in the next 2 weeks what will happen to my yam competition and see which one will produce a fatter tuber at the end of the season. So that's the next update so far. After 3 weeks, guys, the yam that I planted in the yam hole starting to show an appearance, guys. So there it is, about 2 inches tall at the moment. But the yam in the pot decided to start run up the pole, and this one is about 40 centimeters tall. So the one in the pot still doing much better, but at least both is growing now, which is the main thing. So the next time I give you an update when they start leafing out and everything like that. So that's it for now. The yam that's in the yam hill is coming up nicely now. You can see it properly. But the yam that's in the pot, leaves and everything, and it's like almost 4 feet tall now. So this one is growing really fast. Really surprised me. Because I'm thinking the one in the pot will be restricted of nutrients and different things, and it will go slower. But it's shooting up so fast. I remember the same yam seeds I started both of these from, and I tried to root them the exact same time. So yes, guys, that's the other update so far. They all pop up nicely, and one is way ahead of the other one, looking so lovely. Guys, my yam in the pot is over 7 feet tall. We're only in June, guys. Today is the 24th. You see, it's getting right up to the greenhouse ceiling already. Today is the 24th of June, guys. So this is my
update on the comparison of my yam so far. So yes guys, this is my Saint Vincent yam, and the one that's at the in the ground finally found the post. Well, I helped it to get the post, and it's going up, and this one is going towards its 3 feet. So if I dress back and show you guys, I cannot believe how quick this yam is growing. It's just growing and growing and growing and growing and growing and growing some more. So yes guys, that's the latest update on the yam comparison. The Saint Vincent yam has now all grown the pole, both of them. So that's the update between the one that I made a yam hill and the one that's in containers. So if go down to the bottom guys, so this is the one that I dug the hole for. I just water it a little, and it's, you know, this was a slower start one, and so far this one is skinnier, produces less foliage than the one that's in container. So that's that one going up the yam pole, and then it starts wrapping around at the top there, whereas the one that's in the container, there it is, hopefully you can see it start producing. Let's see if I can go from this angle. It start producing another shoot right there, so you can see two vine there, and this one the leaves are much fatter. It produces much better guys. It's just growing. Look at the size of the leaf, it's just growing. And this is the one that's in the container, guys. And the contrast is so funny because look at the leaves and everything. This is the one that is in container. Look much more healthier. It produces way more. It bushes out more, run much faster. And the vine now goes straight up. And it came back down. Hopefully you can see wrapping up over there, trying to get somewhere else to run. But because I ran out of space in the greenhouse, I kind of put up another board across or anything across for it to run, so I just have to make his way now. But I'm surprised that the one in the ground didn't grow much better than the one in the pot. So the next upload guys is gonna be the harvest, so gonna see if the one in the ground, even though the vine is much tinier, not as much leaves or anything, gonna produce a fatter tuber, fatter yam than the one in the container. So the next time you see this upload guys, it will be a harvest comparison of my Saint Vincent yam that's in the ground and my yam that is in container. So I see you on the next upload. Today is the 10th of October. My yam beginning to die back guys, the temperature is changing, so the yam is now dying back. My nice pretty yam, it's dying back because of the cold, so I have to dig under shortly. So this is the one that's in the container. The one that's in the ground is right here. Its leaves going changing as well. So everything is dying back for the season. So in probably 2 weeks' time, like I was in the greenhouse, probably I can wait until the first frost. I'm not sure yet, guys, but it's in the greenhouse. So I'm waiting out as long as possible. And then I will dig under to see if there's anything. And if there's nothing, guys, I have to overwinter this baby for next year. So the next upload of my yam comparison of the one in the pot and the one in the ground, you should be seeing a reveal soon on the next video. Hello and welcome again to AA Home Gardening. Guys, this is the end of my comparison between my yam that being grown in the ground and the yam that is grown in the pot. So guys, if I harvest and there's not much, then you know I just have to overwinter it and continue growing it next year. But the growing season have finished. Look at their leaves dying, guys. See? The growing season is finished. So you can see the leaves are dying back. So it's now harvest time. I'm gonna start harvesting the one that's in the pot first. Okay, so I'm just going to empty the pot out and see if the tubers have formed properly. What do you think, guys? I know we didn't have a long growing season. Ideally, you should have like a good year, but I didn't have that. But I'm going to see if there's anything underneath it. And if not, I'm just going to take the tuber, the seed that's there, overwinter it indoor until next spring. I start all over again. So let the harvest commence. So I'm just going to take off the vine, sadly. I just cut it here just in case I'm overwintering to get a head start. Just cut it off right there. And then I'm going to see if I can take out this stick. It's already reached roof level. So it's hard to maneuver it to get it out. Hope you can see, guys. I'm trying to see. But it's tied onto that. Oh no. I probably have to tilt this thing first. Ah, boy. See if I can tilt it first. Okay. Tilt it. This stick is very long. Okay. That's a lot of work. But the stick now, I can't get it out. It's a very tall stick and I reach the end of the greenhouse. Hold on. Oh boy. I just fight with the stick, guys, and see if I can get it out. Tiring. What am I going here? Doing something there. But anyhow, guys, I don't want to break the stick. Hold on.
What are you guys
talking about? The stick is out now, guys. Hopefully you can see that. So there's a stick. So I'm just gonna turn the yam over now. And hopefully you're at the position where you can see everything. So come on, you need to get up if you need to get up and show. So let's see what's in there. Let's see, guys. I don't know if anything much is in there. Let's take off the dirt by the side and see what's in there. Oh, it's a lot of work, guys. A lot of work. Hopefully, Devonta, make sure I can see. Look like you're sideways. Make sure I can see, baby. I have some plants here. They're going to suffer because they're going to go on it. Okay, wow.
Wow.
Let's go, yam. Hopefully, they can see. Devonta, can you see, babe? Let's go, yam, right there. Since I've outgrown the pot, anyhow. So let's break it down now. There's young egg, guys. I use egg from my kitchen coop for my fertilizer. So you can see the egg there. Hope you can see the root structure on here properly. I want to make sure it's showing properly. Let's break it in and see what size yam is in there. Devon, you look like you're sideways now. Make sure you can see everything, the baby. Let's see what size yam is in there. See if I can get the yam. I harvest some cocoa, guys, and I'm harvesting some yam. Hopefully, I can get enough yam for a meal. What do you think? I don't know. Let's see what size it is. Let's see. There's another piece of yam there. You reach the end of the. Hopefully, hold on, guys. If you look, it had nowhere else to run. It's got smooth. We reached the end of the container. So, I need some deeper container, guys. It reached the end of the container, had nowhere else to run. So let's see. In total, it's not like a piece of yam, guys. Can I complain for the short length of time I was growing this yam to get this size yam. Guys, the yam nice, you see. I had peace in Jamaica, now I carried it straight from Jamaica. So I had it fresh from the farm where the farmer. Let's see if I can see the old seed. I think that's the old seed right there. So I carried it straight from Jamaica where
the farmer freshly dug it up from the land, went straight in the pot. Guys, make sure you have some nice piece of yam in England. No, you can't see my yam, guys. That's a size of a piece of yam. Okay, can you see the yam? Make sure you can see the yam. So yes, guys, so the smooth bit is, it reached the end of the container, but yes, that's my yam. So that's one harvest. Guys, that's yam grown here in Colcol, UK. Can you believe that, guys? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Guys, I'm so happy. Nice piece of yam. Look at that size yam. Wow. So I'm going to look at the one in the ground now. I don't expect much from the one that's in the ground. I'm just going to put this aside right here. Oh, nice piece of yam. And then I'm going to try and dug the one. This one, the foliage wasn't that good, guys. So I don't know what size yam is there. But I'm happy with the one that's in the bucket. Yes, guys. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be eating yam, my own yam. Guys, I mean, it's tiny. But guess what? From there to there, that's more than a hand palm. Pounds in my hand there of yam. That's all fresh yam to eat. I need to have grown some more, guys, if you had space. So let's get rid of some of this dirt and then try and harvest the one in the yam hill. But the one in the yam hill, guys, it did not have enough vine like the one in the container. It could be a positive or a negative, so some kind of energy go in the vine and not in the tuber. So let's see if that was the case for it, because it didn't have lots and lots of leaves. So we need to dig away now at the yam hill that was right here. So let's see which one did better, guys, the one that was in the container or the one that was in the ground. And as I said, this one, it didn't have a lot of foliage. You can see that's the yam seed that I planted right there. So let's see if the yam is gone down into the ground, guys. Let's see if the yam gone down into the ground. Let's see what's going on here. So far, I don't see anything so far. Let's see. So you're gonna tell me, guys, that the yam that was planted in the container did better, because I'm gonna see that, oops, break off the seed of the yam. I'm gonna store this again, the plant back. So let's see. I don't see anything yet. That's interesting. So you're gonna tell me that the one that was planted in, I can feel a tiny piece now. But you're telling me that the one that was planted in the, well, I have to dig it up for you guys, because I'm doing a comparison for yam in ground versus yam in ground. I'm gonna break it, baby. The yam in ground versus the wrong in the container. So I have to show you the entire end product of this, because, oh guys, let's see. And then I have to put them together and compare them. I can see a long piece of yam going down there now. I can see a yam, but it seems like a small piece of yam. Guys, can you imagine? I'm in England digging for yam. This is England in Colcol, UK, guys. I'm here digging through for yam. Can you believe that? You cannot write this in a book, guys. Could somebody tell me that somebody could be digging in autumn as well, in cold autumn, digging for yam? The yam gone down, guys. Tiny though, very skinny. Oh guys, this is what I'm doing for you guys. Guys, I hope I appreciate these detailed videos. Please like and share to others that we can grow nice tropical Jamaican yam. Yeah, or any tropical yam we can grow here in Colcol, UK. So you see, whoopie daisy. So this is the one in the ground, guys. So I'm really, really surprised that my yam that was in the container did much, much better. Look how fatter this is than the yam that was in the ground. Can you see that, guys? We planted it at the same time. You saw all the process. Everything was the same. And the one
that was in the container did much better than the one that was in the ground. But guess what, guys? What I'm gonna do, because this was in the ground, yeah, I'm just gonna dig up a ground and make this soil a bit more looser, and I'm gonna try and overwinter this one just as it is. Is it gonna work? I don't know. It's the first I'm gonna try and overwinter it, but the experiment is different. I'm gonna eat this one. This is good size piece of yam. I'm gonna eat this one. This one, I'm Papa Yam Man. I'm gonna try and see if I can overwinter it as it is. I don't know if it's gonna work, but I'm gonna try. So I'm just gonna make this soil quite loose so it can go down if you want to go down and get fat and thing. But yes guys, happy days. I've grown yam here in Cole, UK. Guys, share. Show people that it's possible to grow our tropical food that we love here in Cole region. So until next time, guys, keep gardening, and thank you so much for coming on the journey with me. Until next time, keep gardening. Take care now. Bye-bye.
Like, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell.